webinar on Vigilance Awareness Week in collaboration with South Central Railway. I am Lieutenant Dr. Kavita. On behalf of our management and my own behalf, would like to thank all the dignitaries, organizers, students present in the gathering and gracing the occasion. I welcome Professor G. Damodar Garu, Vice Chancellor, Chaitanya DMT University. Today's speaker, Ma'am Chandrima Roy, Senior Deputy GM of Chief and Chief Vigilance Officer, South Central Railway. Organizers and my colleagues, Professor G. Vijay and Dr. D. Gopinath, and my dear cadets, volunteers, and all my dear students. As you know, today we are gathered here to attend a webinar on Vigilance Awareness Week. It's a great pleasure and privilege to me to welcome you all for today's webinar on Vigilance India, Prosperous India. As you know, the theme of this year is Satark Bharat, Samriddh Bharat. So, har ghar tak satarkata failana hai, Bharat desh ko samriddh banana hai. So, you are the future generation. You have to take the vigilance toward the country and you make the India prosperous. And as you know, 2020 Vigilance Awareness Week was announced by Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji. And we are carrying forward the awareness regarding the Vigilance India. So the Central Vigilance Commission observes the Vigilance Awareness Week from 27th October to November 2nd every year. This is observed every year during the week in which the birthday of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel falls. So this Awareness Week campaign affirms our commitment to the promotion of integrity and prosperity in public life through citizen participation. This year, Vigilance Awareness Week is observed with Satark Bharat, Samriddh Bharat theme, which was finalized after putting the suggestive themes on the website and obtaining the opinion of Chief Vigilance Officers on the proposed theme for the year. So today, I warmly welcome all of you for this webinar. So now we will have a shloka, prayer song by D. Stravanti. It's your turn, Stravanti.
Okay, ma'am. Jai Hind, ma'am. A very pleasant good morning to all the lecturers and everyone present here. I am Cadet Stravanti from BSc final year. So I would like to start the webinar with Saraswati Mantra.
या कुंदेन्दु तुषार हार दवला या शुभ्र वस्त्रावृत या वीणा वरदंड मंडित करा या श्वेत पद्मासना या ब्रह्माच्युत शंकर प्रभृति देवैः सदा वंदिता सा मां पातु सरस्वती भगवती निःशेष जाड्यापहा या कुंदेन्दु तुषार हार धवला या शुभ्र वस्त्रावृता या वीणा वरदंड मंडित करा या श्वेत पद्मासना या ब्रह्माच्युत शंकर प्रभृति देवैः सदा वंदिता सा मां पातु सरस्वती भगवती निःशेष जाड्यापहा.
Thank you. Thank you, Shravanti. That was an illuminating sloka of Goddess Saraswati. Now we'll move on to the next session. So now we have the messages from our NCC cadets and the NSS volunteers. So I would like to call upon Senior Under Officer V. Shivani.
Thank you, ma'am. I would like to share my screen. Ma'am, is it okay?
Yeah, it's okay.
Yes, yes.
Jai Hind. Good morning to everyone. I, Junior Under Officer V. Shivani from Chaitanya Deemed to be University, pursuing BSc final year from 8th Telangana Girls Battalion, Warangal Group, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana Directorate. I am here to speak about Vigilant India, Prosperous India. Every year, in the last week of October or first week of November, the Central Vigilance Commission, CVC, to create awareness among the public of the corruption as well as to bring awareness on the importance of probity in public life, organize a week along Vigilance Awareness Week. Together we fight, together we fall, and together we shall shine bright. India today is what India needs. The slogan of Atmanirbhar. After the recent global development and the various reasons, the need of national security and being alert and the vigilant has become that much more important. The alert related, the borders, data privacy, and all others is what every citizen should be and should do. If we all alerted and vigilant in our everyday life, by doing small checks, we will be safe from every other things. The prosperity of the nation depends upon the citizen and how they help the nation, the citizens, and do not let anyone other misuses the useful information. The military plans, the development projects, the budget planning, etc. are many of the important data that need vigilance and security of all the time. The prosperity of the country will be always in upward direction. If the government and citizens both are vigilant and keep the pace with the modern and evolving markets around the globe. The data and knowledge of current happening allows the nation to be cautious and take required step toward the prosperity with more keys. Finally, I conclude, be aware, be safe, be together, be brave. The complete trust and the feeling of the togetherness plays a vital role in the prosperity of the nation, helping in the indigenous businessman and organization, purchase of local goods, etc. It helps in boosting confidence and economy and hence enhances the brand value of the nation, and thus it helps us prosper. I finally thank Chaitanya Deemed to be University to collaborating with our National Cadet Corps and National Service Scheme and Indian Railway. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Shivani. Thank you, Shivani. That was a nice presentation. Now we will move on to the next session. I would like to call upon Junior Under Officer P. Sai Sahasra to speak about the session.
Jai Hind, ma'am.
Yeah, Jai Hind.
Jai Hind, respected AMOs, I'm the guest and the speaker and my dear co-cadets who are present here. A warm welcome to everyone and good morning. I'm here to speak a few words on Vigilant India and Prosperous India. The Central Vigilance Commission has decided to observe the Vigilance Awareness Week from October 22nd to November 2nd this year with the theme of Vigilant India, Prosperous India. Vigilance Awareness Week is being celebrated every year and coincides with the birthday of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, known as the Man of High Integrity. And the purpose of Vigilance Awareness Week is to generate awareness in the public at large about to feel effects of corruption. And in this addition, the commission has asked government organizations to focus on internal activities which are to be taken up in the campaign made as part of the Vigilance Awareness Week. In this property, the watchdog has issued guidelines for the government departments to carry out such internal activities, including inspection of relevant records, disposal of complaints pending over 6 months, and finalizing of minor and major penalty, among others. The observance of Vigilance Awareness Week would commence with the integrity pledge by the service in the ministries, departments, central public sectors, and the public sector banks and other organizations. Mainly, the commission aims that all the organizations to conduct the various activities with zeal to achieve the objective to eliminate corruption in public life. In my view, the first tool is education. With the help of the education, we can reduce the corruption. According to the report by Transparency International, the least corrupt state is Kerala. Because in the literacy rate, the Kerala is in the highest position. In most of the states, normally a fairly large number of people are uneducated. Those who are uneducated do not know about the process and provisions and procedure that through which they can get justice. By the corrupt public servants try to make fool of them and often demand them. This is due to unawareness of the people of law and public rights, and an uneducated person suffer out corrupt society. That we can avoid this by our education. Generally, think adage, by our education we can change anything. And by until and unless we are not honest, we cannot control corruption. That our the cadets, we are the citizens of the tomorrow. That we should be truth and we should be faithful to our professional life. If we are faithful to our professional life, we can change anything. So I suggest you cadets that be faithful and be truthful to our professional life, then no corruption is more. Jai Hind and thank you.
Good, a simple correction regarding pronunciation. It's vigilance, not ga, not vigilance, vigilance. Hope other speakers will pronounce it correctly. It's okay, go ahead.
Thank you, sir. So we will move on for the next message by Cadet T. Bharat from final year MPCS.
Thank you, ma'am. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.
A pleasant morning to everyone present here. I, Cadet T. Bharat of Chaitanya Dimatubi University, I feel honored to speak on the occasion of a Vigilance Awareness Week on behalf of NCC Boys Company, Chaitanya Dimatubi University. I would also take this opportunity to speak and share my ideas on Vigilance Awareness Week. Let me tell you a short point which speakers before me don't mention. That point is, the Central Vigilance Commission has decided to observe Vigilance Awareness Week from 27 November to 2nd of October this year. And let me tell you, the theme for this year is Vigilant India, Prosperous India. Let me go on with a incident which will tell what how Vigilant India will make us a prosperous India. The incident is, when you go for buying grocery or anything, we will have some, and it cost rupees, 4 rupees 50 paise. Usually the shopkeeper will take 5 rupees from us. Do you people think it is of a fair means? And I think many of you think that vigilance means only stopping corruption, and to stop corruption is the only way you think we are vigilant. I think that's absolutely wrong. Vigilance means we should be vigilant in all aspects. That may be our education, that may be our career, that may be our anything which we face in life. Let me go on with my example. We buy an item for 4 rupees 50 paise and we pay 5 rupees. Here we are losing 50 paise. If the shopkeeper go on doing this, he will be becoming rich and the poor will be becoming poor. To avoid this, we need to use, I also say that it is impossible to pay 4 rupees 50 paise because 50 paise is not available right now. So we if we want to pay 4 rupees 50 paise, we need to go online transactions. If we need to do online transactions, then we need to be educated. Automatically, if we need, if we are automatically get developed. That's my idea. Hope you all understand it. And many of we pledge during this this kind of events, like during voting Voters Day, we'll pledge we'll vote without we'll vote for the nation and we'll strive hard for this nation. And during Vigilance Week, we'll undergo pledges and we'll take pledge. And we forget about it the next minute. We'll just the pledge only comes from our mouth, not from our heart. I request all to please implement that pledge in your life. Hope this everyone will implement this in the future. And sorry to say this, I think India is more democratic in nature, more than enough because. Someone should be always be behind us, and someone should always push us to do the things we are doing. Like, yeah, it's our responsibility to vote for the nation's development, but no one will vote until some vote chief election officer or someone imposes us to do so. And during this, actually, vigilance is. We need to be vigilant. It's our responsibility to be vigilant. But we people are never mind of these things, and we are busy in our day-to-day life. We are so busy that we need, we won't do our works, and we will keep on judging others. I request all to any change which should happen in the world should start from ourselves. That means if I want to see a corrupt free India, then I should not be corrupted person. I should be a trustworthy person to say something. If I want to say India should be developed and educated, first I should be educated. That's the main thing. And I would like to mention a quote of Mahatma Gandhi, be the change which you want to see in the world. That means any change which you want to see in others should start from yourself. Thank you for giving this opportunity. Thank you, everyone.
Exactly, Bharat. The change should start from our homes itself. That means the change should start from a person. Then we can see a change in our country. And you are the people who have to come up with those changes. That's why we planned this webinar, so that the students' community can be awakened. Okay, then we'll go to the next session by volunteer Durga Prasad, BBM final year.
A very pleasant good morning to everyone. This is Durga Vara Prasad, Chaitanya Deemed to the University, senior NSS volunteer, pursuing BBM final year. The theme on Vigilant India, Prosperous. Every year or in the importance of poverty in public life. And the Central Vigilance Commission has decided that this year the Vigilance Awareness Week would be observed from 27th October to November 2nd, 2020. With the theme, Sartak Bharat, Samrudh Bharat, Vigilant India, Prosperous India. And this commission expects all central government and all organizations to conduct various activities with zeal and enthusiasm to achieve objective to eliminate corruption in public life. And Vigilance Awareness Week gives us message that corruption nowadays is being aggressive. If necessary steps are not taken, the country situation in future will be depressive. And everyone knows India is the world's largest democracy with the 1.3 billion population in the world. So as our country is one of the powerful countries in the world, and presently we are moving towards progress, it also facing any problem. One of them is corruption. Nowadays, most widely spread epidemic in India is corruption. And there is hardly any office in both private and public sector that is untouched from corruption. And some greedy people of our country are betraying their own country for money. And no one can't able to tell how much loss of the economy is suffered due to this corruption. And it is very surprising that earlier bribe was paid for getting wrong things done. But currently, today, now bribe is paid for getting right things done at right time. The one thing we need to understand that corruption can be removed. Corruption can be removed only by the active participation of the people. And we need to take the first step of not paying bribe for our work. So I can say this quotation, vigilance and honesty are the best which can stop the spreading corruption. And Vigilance Awareness Week also inspires us to raise our voice against corruption. The new theme of Vigilance Awareness Week, Vigilant India, Prosperous India, makes us ever to be vigilant so that our country can prosper. So we should be vigilant. If someone asks for a bribe, immediately we can complain to the police. Many times we have seen that people fear the consequences and reprisal of those against whom they report. In the end, all I can say that we have the power to fight against corruption. Just be vigilant for the country and try to pay all the lawful taxes, penalties to the government so that country becomes prosperous. Therefore, I conclude this message. Corruption is a stigma. Please think, if it increases, our country progress will sink. I will repeat. Corruption is a stigma. Please think, if it increases, our country progress will sink. And thank you each and everyone for giving this wonderful opportunity. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Durga Prasad. That was a nice quote at the last. And today we'll go to the last volunteer, Ms. Gayatri, BTBCC second year, to share her views.
Firstly, very pleasant good morning to everyone. This is Gayatri, BTBCC, pursuing from BTBCC, second year, NSS volunteer. Firstly, I'll start with a quote. Like, the theme is Vigilant India, and then Vigilant India, Prosperous India. Raise your voice against bribe taker and be vigilant and make India prosperous and greater country. It is said that change is necessary with the time, and in the same way it is necessary for every person to be vigilant to make country prosperous. The theme of Vigilant Awareness, which is Vigilant India Prosperous, like the theme is Vigilant India and Prosperous India, also gives a message that every person should be vigilant so that no one can take advantage of you. And the vigilance and intelligence of every person takes a country to new heights. Today is a duty of every person to cooperate the development of the country and not to be intelligent. But sadly, today every person is not contributing in the development of the country, but in the doing the legal issues regarding to the societies. And increasing, like today it is mostly increasing in the pollution and development, depletion of natural disasters, poverty, corruption, other negligence. But as a responsible person of India, we will ever try to do anything except the shouting at the government. And most of
thank you, Gayatri. So now I request our Honorable Vice Chancellor of Chaitanya Deemed to be University to give his message.
Thank you, Lieutenant Kavita. At the beginning, let me congratulate all the speakers who have highlighted the salient features of this resilience awareness program that we are conducting now. The first one, Shivani, has made an impressive PPT, followed by Sri Saharsha, and she has rightly remarked that education reduces corruption, and she has given the example of Kerala. So if we are more educated, if all are educated, if all are digitally knowledge, have digital knowledge for transactions, it reduces our corruption. Bharat, Durga Prasad and Gayatri have also covered some very good points. I congratulate them. So esteemed our guest speaker, Madam Chandrima Roy, Senior Deputy General Manager and the Civil Vigilance Officer, South Central Railway. Thank you, Madam, for proposing this very good program to celebrate in collaboration with our university. We thank you. We all know that corruption is one of the major problems we are facing now. Is my voice clear?
Yes, sir.
This corruption hampers our social, political, educational, and economic growth. Now, see, an unfortunate incident has happened. Somebody created a fake website of our university yesterday only. And he offers many courses which we don't offer. And he might be promising even to sell the degrees also. So we are lodging a complaint with Cybercrime. So this corruption even spoils education growth also. We all should remember that fighting corruption is not the job of a single individual or agency. It's a collective and coordinated effort. It requires synergy. Several bodies, agencies, NGOs, law enforcing departments, and law-abiding citizens have to come together to eradicate corruption. The corrupt should be punished without any delay. Our attitude should also change. We should follow the rules. Some of us unnecessarily encourage deviation of rules and get the work done by illegal means. We should not take or offer bribe. Let us perform all our actions in an honest and transparent manner. We should act in public interest. We should be sincere and honest in our behavior. We should report all incidents of corruption to the appropriate agency. DBT, Direct Money Transfer System, this Direct Beneficiary Transfer System, DBT has reduced a lot of corruption in government transactions. Yesterday, our Honorable Prime Minister was making this remark in Gujarat. This DBT saved 1.70 lakh crores from falling into the hands of middlemen and is being implemented in 351 schemes of 51 ministries, including our education sector. Our students, you know, will be receiving a scholarship amount direct to their accounts. So move towards one tax, demonetization, insolvency, and bankruptcy code are welcome changes. Technology has made us helpless in transport offenses. Now everybody is forced to follow traffic rules. If they jump the traffic signal, say automatic this is a surveillance system takes the photographs and sends you the receipt of fine. So this technology is really making us helpless in several offenses. The new policies seek to have zero tolerance with corruption by tapping black money, restricting terror funding, unauthorized foreign funding, tax evasion, and increasing revenue sources. Unfortunately, even now, India is the 80th least corrupt nation out of 108 countries, according to 2019 Corruption Perceptions Index reported by Transparency International. We are still at 80th position in corruption. Most of us are really unhappy to see this bad ranking for India. India should be at the top like Denmark, Finland, New Zealand, Sweden, Singapore, and Switzerland. I have visited all these countries except Finland. These six countries are perceived as the top five least corruption nations in the world, ranking consistently high among international financial transparency. While the most perceived corrupt country in the world, can anyone mention the most corrupt country in the world? Can anyone mention in the chat box which is the most corrupt country in the world? Why should we give importance to the most corrupt country? Let us be, let us take the most honest, good countries as our examples. Let me share an anecdote here. Singapore Prime Minister Lee Kuan Yew once said that there were two options for him. He said, I quote, "Either I get corrupted and put my family in the Forbes list of the richest people in the world and leave my people with nothing, or I serve my country, my people, and let my country be in the list of the best 10 economies in the world. I choose the second option," unquote. See how honest he is. Some corrupt Indian politicians remarked, I quote, "There were two options for us too, but the second option was already taken by the Singapore Prime Minister. We had no other choice," unquote. Such is the bad attitude of some of our politicians. So when our people are highly educated, then they will teach a lesson to them. Now politicians know that even educated persons are ready to sell their votes. This trend has to change. If human values are taught at home and in school, like in Denmark, Finland, New Zealand, Sweden, Singapore, and Switzerland, our Bharat will also be like one of them. Hope new National Education Policy 2020 will fill this gap. For Mahatma Gandhi, there are seven deadly sins: wealth without work, pleasure without conscience, science without humanity, knowledge without character, politics without principles, commerce without morality, and finally, worship without sacrifice. We should not commit these seven sins. Recently, we have seen the suicide case of a Guinness record holder of corruption. What is that horrible life? What a tragic ending he had. The entire nation is vigilant now, fighting for justice for the deported popular Hindi actor Sushant Singh Rajput, exposing the darker side of Bollywood. On October 16th, 5 days ago, a 18-year-old Chechen refugee in France beheaded a school teacher, Samuel Patu, who was just teaching him freedom of expression. The teacher was flagrantly attacked and murdered. All these unfortunate endings are due to lack of moral education with ethics. Everybody wants growth, progress, and success without understanding their basic meanings. Please watch this video for 2 minutes. What Swamiji explains about growth, progress, and success. Meanwhile, some of you can define your definitions of real growth, real progress, real success. Now I will share that brief, impressive video for 2 minutes. So again, it takes time. That was my granddaughter. So sorry, it takes time. It's there in my 6,000 videos collection. It takes time to search. So Swamiji explains in the video that progress, material increase. Progress is material increase. He says material increase is growth. Mere material increase is growth. But growth with ethics is real progress, he says. But progress with morality, humanity, and spirituality is the real progress, he says. As the Vice Chancellor of Chaitanya DM2B University, I am proud to share the news that our university follows ethical practices, maintains strict standards, and fosters a culture of honesty and integrity. It commits to good corporate governance based on transparency and accountability. Our madam should know that even our decisions taken at the university are taken in consultation with all the staff members, teaching, non-teaching, and students. Our university adheres relevant laws, rules, and regulations. It projects the rights and interests of all stakeholders and the society at large. All the employees of our university follow a code of ethics. Here is good news to all NCC cadets who are actively participating in today's program. On 74th Independence Day, our Honorable Prime Minister Modi ji announced that 1 lakh NCC cadets, including 1/3 girls, you should be proud of it. So including 1/3 of girls will be trained by Army, Navy, and Air Force. This trained manpower can play an important role in disaster management, and the youth will also get skill training and opportunity for a career in the armed forces. And the process has begun. The certificate of commitment issued by Central Vigilance Commission expects all of us to adopt the integrity pledge. We'll be taking that pledge at the end of this program. So this pledge expects us to commit to uphold highest standards of honesty and integrity and to follow probity and rule of law in all walks of life. We'll be taking the integrity pledge very soon. So, dear participants, I'm waiting for the day when Bharat, when our beloved country Bharat becomes a proud nation without any corruption. To make it a reality, we all should be honest, sincere, and vigilant at all times and strengthen the hands that fight against corruption. Hope my Bharat will be more vigilant every day, not once in a year when we celebrate our Vigilance Week celebrations. So we should be more vigilant every day and become prosperous morally, spiritually, socially, digitally, and educationally. Jai Hind without corruption. Over to you, madam.
Thank you, sir. So, very thought-provoking words, sir. So, as you said, people, if they understand about correct growth, I think corruption may end at any sometime. We may hope for that. So next we'll go to the next session. So it's a message by guest speaker, ma'am. Ma'am Chandrima Roy, Senior Deputy General Manager and Chief Vigilance Officer, South Central Railway. Ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Kavita ji. And I hope I'm audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Your voice is very clear.
Thank you. Okay, a very good morning to all of you. I see there are about 95 participants in this today. And to begin with, let me thank Professor G. Damodar for having readily agreed to have this webinar for the students. You know, as all of you have been mentioning, we do observe the Vigilance Awareness Week every year. And one of the programs, activities that we do is outreach programs for schools, students, college students, etc. Unfortunately, since Secunderabad has so many schools, colleges, universities, we usually limit our activities to the Twin Cities. But this year, you know, there are some positive aspects of this pandemic. One of them is how it has rapidly digitalized us. And this webinar, I think 1 year back, most of us were not so familiar with webinars. Now webinar has become the talk of the day. Everybody knows how to take part in a webinar. You have different platforms. So because of this availability of having webinars and, you know, shortening the distance, I thought, why not we approach some other place other than the Twin Cities? Warangal happens to be in Secunderabad division of our South Central Railway. And that is why we chose Warangal. And Professor Damodar was very willing. I mean, he did not hesitate even once. In fact, he took up the whole responsibility. Thank you very much. And I would like to thank Lieutenant Dr. Kavita also. She has been organizing very well. I'm highly impressed by the cadets. I know that NCC teaches you discipline, and it really came across very well by the disciplined way and the good thoughts that the youngsters brought out. It is really very heartening to see the youngsters thinking right, because as I'm sure Professor Damodar and Kavita ji will agree with me, we have already passed that stage. Our morals, values, ethics have all been set now. But it is these youngsters who are the future. I think Kavita ji had told that you are the future of this country, future of not only the nation, but future of the world. The whole world depends on you, because if you become strong pillars of strength for this economy, then we will flourish. If you are weak, like strong only outside, but weak inside, then definitely we will not progress. This year, we have had a very good theme. Every year we come up with a theme. And this year it is Vigilant India, Prosperous India. Vigilant India, all of you have been saying how each and every person needs to be vigilant. That means needs to be alert. Needs to be alert not only about themselves, that is what is happening within themselves, but also what is happening in the society and how they can make a change. Because, you know, our values over the years have been changing. I liked it very much when Professor Damodar defined progress not only in terms of money, but he also talked about spiritual progress. You know, progress has to be an all-round thing. It cannot be just limited to one dimension of our life. Because all of us know, once you are born in this world, you will die. And when you die, you do not take anything with you. You do not take all the material goods. So therefore, you have to progress in your character. You have to progress spiritually. You have to progress materially also, because a poor man who doesn't have anything will definitely not be thinking of any other aspect. He will only be thinking of the food which he requires or the money that he requires to buy the food. So therefore, we need to progress all round. And I liked it very much when the young student, I think it was Bharat, who said that, you know, it has to come from within. Why should we celebrate it only once or observe a Vigilance Awareness Week or take various pledges? I think throughout the year we are taking pledges. We should not limit ourselves to just one day. It should be an ongoing activity. I think your NCC is an ongoing activity where your values are getting reiterated all the time. I would suggest one more thing for all of you. In your college, you can have what is known as an integrity club. You know, integrity club, what do we mean by it? A small group of people form a club where the whole purpose of the club is to promote integrity. What do we mean by integrity? Integrity is not only honesty. Integrity also means, you know, whatever your output is, it should be the best. So this group will not only look at whether you're promoting honesty or not, they will also look at what are how to help others around you. You know, all of us are not gifted with the same abilities. So how to help people who have lesser abilities? You know, you can help your other students so that, you know, the weaker students are not tempted to do something which is unethical. You know, when you have not studied for the examination, the temptation is there because you have to pass the examination. You have the temptation where you feel, okay, let me see what my neighbor is writing. So you try to see what the neighbor is writing and cheating. If it is a digital examination, maybe you open a book and you try to. So by doing this, you are fooling yourself and you're not going to make any progress. So this integrity club, you can help people who are weaker than you. You can have various debates and discussions, because, you know, when you say that you should not break rules, there are many rules which are very difficult to implement. So how do we ensure that rules are not broken? By simplification of rules. You can see that over the years, the government of India also is simplifying rules, you know, and making things more easy. Like even simple things like payment of electricity bill or, you know, opening a shop. These used to be so difficult. Then we had the liberalization of the economy. We have digitalization of the economy, where now you can sit at home and you can pay your electricity bill, you can pay your water bill. You don't have to go and stand in the queue. You don't have to bribe the clerk. I'm in a hurry, so please take 10 rupees extra and you take the payment of my bill first. So these kind of things, simplification of rules is taking place all the time. Now, what this integrity club formed by the students, you can see, even you can start from your own university or your hostel. You know, many of you might be staying in the hostel. So you see whether there are some rules which are being broken often by people, which are being violated. So there may be a reason why these rules are being violated. That is because they are not able to follow the rules. So you should come up with suggestions as to how the rules can be implemented in such a way that nobody is tempted to break the rules. Then, you know, to make things interesting, you can have small skits, you know, what you call Nukkad Natak, you know, to promote integrity amongst everybody. For example, when people say that there are two things which are very important in life. One is your health and second is your integrity. Because if you lose either one of them, you cannot regain it back. So that is why all of us should aim to see that we do not lose our integrity. Because finally, it is not the police, it is not the prison, which you know you should be frightened of. It is yourself. Because the whole world may not know what you have done, but you yourself know what you have done. As many of you have said, education is very important. You know, for us, education has become learning of just books. That is, you pass your exam, you become BSc, MSc, PhD, and you are supposed to be very highly educated. But there is a difference between education and literacy. When you're having a whole host of degrees, many times this is just a mark of your literacy. It is not a mark of your education. Education is something which is an all-round growth, which already Professor Damodar has said, that you have to grow. It's not a unidimensional thing where, you know, you can read, write, and you can present some ideas. It is a multidimensional. From all dimensions, you have to grow. And this education, that is why ethics and morality is very important. And I'm very happy that Chaitanya Deemed to Be University is giving so much emphasis on the ethics part of education. All of you, even in your NCC, whatever you are being taught, please internalize. You know, that is what is most important. Because until you start believing, it is no use taking a pledge until you start believing it, until you start practicing it. And practice has to be a continuous process. See, many of you are sports persons. If you stop playing, say you are a very good cricketer, but if you stop playing for 5-6 years, will you be able to compete with the others? Will you be able to do a good job? No. It is only if you continuously practice, or if you are a good singer, you know, you will be able to give a good performance only if you continue to practice. So ethics is also something which you have to continue to practice. There is no doubt that, you know, everybody cannot become ethical. There will be some, but it is our job, it is our duty to ensure that everybody around us understands the advantages of good ethics. You know, we have been talking a lot about the digital India. That is, everything, if you digitalize, then corruption gets lowered. But there is another aspect to this, because with all this digitalization, your cyber crime is also increasing. Professor Damodar himself gave an example of cyber crime where somebody has made a website. See, in railways, the job in railways is something which is highly prized. So we have something called a railway recruitment board, which is an independent authority which conducts these online examinations. And everything is put out on the website. But when the examinations are being conducted or when notifications are being given, there are so many these fake websites which come. Exactly, with all the logos, everything, names. It is just a clone of the website which is given for Railway Recruitment Board. And they are taking money from various people, from the candidates, and saying, ki you give us 10 lakhs, we will get you a job. This has become rampant. So I think one of you said that giving a bribe is as much, it is as much of a wrongdoing as taking a bribe. So if you are willing to pay the 10 lakhs, you know, first of all, you should think that let me get the job through my abilities. If I'm good enough, if I do well, then I will get the job. Now, if each of us keeps thinking of this, then, and I will not pay even a single penny for getting that job, then the whole system gets uncorrupted, you know. An anti-corruption institution or anti-corruption organization or the Central Vigilance Commission or the, you know, vigilance departments in different ministries, they alone cannot stop corruption, because corruption will continue till there are people willing to take shortcuts, people willing to make that extra payment and not do the hard work and get something which they do not deserve. You know, you have college students, in before the examination, there is always this, can I get the question paper in advance so that I can prepare? It's not that I'm going to cheat, but let me know the questions in advance. So what is that? That is something that you do not want to prepare the whole syllabus, and you do not want to study everything and appear for the examination. You want a shortcut. So everywhere, whether it is in your examination, whether it is in getting admissions, whether it is in getting a job, you know, we get so many recommendations. Once you get a job, then you say, no, let me be posted here. See, if everybody follows a priority, always for postings, there is something called merit, what is your requirement. There are certain requirements you might have for posting somewhere. So, and there is a priority list, like a waiting list. Okay, you want to get posted to Warangal, so your priority number 5. Now you say, no, please give me out of priority, because each of us thinks that we are more deserving than the others. The day we stop thinking that, thinking only about ourselves, because I think another aspect of corruption is selfishness. When you start thinking only about yourself and not about the others, you want things that you do not deserve. You know, to quote Mahatma Gandhi, he had said that earth has enough for everybody's need, but it does not have enough for everybody's greed. So when you are selfish and you want to appropriate everything, see, you are given the ability to eat only a limited quantity. So why do we keep hoarding things? You can spend only a limited amount of money. So why do we keep collecting money? So the day I think all of us start believing that let me have only that much as I require in this life, I think that day we will be able to eradicate as much corruption as is possible. There will be some one or two bad apples, but we do not have to make the whole crop rotten because of those one or two bad apples. Okay, thank you very much for having given me this opportunity, and thank all of you for having taken time off on your Sunday and participated in this function. And I hope that you will form your integrity club, and it will be a very vibrant association that you have. And maybe next year again, we can meet during this time to take stock of what you have done throughout the year. I wish all of you the very best in life. May you have a wonderful life and full of ethics and morality, and may you succeed. And with your success, the country will also succeed and progress. Thank you very much. Now, usually we have the integrity pledge. So would you like to take the integrity pledge?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm not very familiar with Zoom. Let me see if I can share the screen with the pledge. Otherwise, I will read it out.
And you can share the screen, ma'am.
I'll try to share the screen. Actually, it is available on the Google. If you just
shall I read out, ma'am?
Yeah, you have it. You can read out, and we can all repeat after you.
Okay, ma'am. So here we go. We shall promote.
We shall promote.
We shall promote.
Ethical business practices.
Ethical business practices.
Just a second, Kavita ji.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Actually, I think that is integrity pledge for organizations.
Yes.
I have. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, 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 ma'am.
Yeah.
Integrity pledge for citizens.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so this is the pledge. Kavita ji, you can start reading it. I think all of us will repeat with you.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Are you able to see this?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. Yes. To follow probity and rule of law. In all walks of life. To neither take nor offer bribe. To perform all tasks in an honest and transparent manner. To act in public interest. To lead by example. Exhibiting integrity in personal behavior. To report any incident.
To the appropriate agency.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. So with your words, actually we already have a club. We do social activities, and we will enhance the integrity also in that club, ma'am. We'll continue the same thing from your words.
Very good.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
So it's the turn of my learned colleague, Mr. Professor Lieutenant G. Vijay, to give vote of thanks.
Well, good afternoon to all. I myself, Lieutenant Dr. G. Vijay, Associate NCC Officer of Chaitanya Deemed to University. It is indeed a great honor and privilege for me to propose a vote of thanks in this important virtual program of Vigilance Week celebrations in coordination with South Central Railway. First and foremost, I thank our guest speaker, Madam Chandrima Roy, Senior Deputy General Manager and Chief Vigilance Officer, South Central Railway, Secunderabad, for her informative and knowledgeable awareness talk on Vigilant India, Prosperous India. Madam, our students are benefited a lot through your effective presentation. I am confident that they have enhanced their knowledge of Indian vigilance system. On behalf of Chaitanya Deemed to be University, Warangal, and on my personal behalf, I wholeheartedly extend my sincere thanks to you, Madam, on your remarkable contribution in this session. I extend my sincere thanks to Professor Damodar Garu, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Chaitanya Deemed to be for gracing this program and delivering a motivational message to the students. Thank you so much, sir, for your encouragement and extended support for this program. Let me convey my thanks to the group of NCC cadets and NSS volunteers. Cadet B. Shivani, Sri Sahasra, T. Bharat, volunteer Durga Prasad and Gayatri, who have exceptionally given their support in this program by giving their short but sweet speeches on the significance of vigilance. I also extend my sincere thanks to Madam Lieutenant Dr. P. Kavita, Associate NCC Officer, and the moderator of her excellent way of conducting this program. I thank Dr. P. Gopinath, NSS Program Officer of Chaitanya Deemed University, for his impressive contribution in this program. Finally, before I conclude, I must say that the audience have been exceptional. Without the discipline and extremely engaged audience, an academic program like this cannot be successful. Thank you so much, dear NCC cadets and NSS volunteers, for your active participation in this program. Thank you so much, madam. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am, for spending your valuable time on this Sunday. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kavita ji. Thank you very much.
Thank you, madam.